Dear colleagues, conference participants, let me present the results of our study on using online lexicons as sources of domain-specific terminology in translation. The term lexicon comes from the ancient Greek dictionary and is a reference book or dictionary in the broad sense. In addition, this term has sometimes previously been used synonymously with linguistic vocabulary. In the modern sense, a lexicon is mainly seen as a factual reference book. A distinction is made between a lexicon in the narrow sense and an encyclopedia, depending on its volume. From a lexicographic perspective, a distinction is also made between a dictionary as a source of linguistic information and a lexicon as a collection of information. Given the history of the emergence and development of such a category of publication as lexicons, it is worth noting that they exist mainly in the printed version. Now, lexicons also have numerous websites that present different types of information. The main content of the lexicon in book form is divided into articles, while the online versions of the lexicons have separate websites. The articles in the printed lexicons are not arranged alphabetically and by index, but are organized alphabetically according to their keywords. The keyword is at the beginning of the entry and is separated from the text of the entry in a certain way. The function of keywords in online vocabularies is performed by headings, and the required information searched for can be found using the programmed internal search functions or via internet search engines. In its current general application, a vocabulary is usually understood as a collection of data that deals not only with general knowledge topics, but also explains specialized topics in detail. Vocabularies of various specialization, political, economic, computer, agricultural, etc. There is still no consensus among linguists and lexicographers on the essence and purpose of lexicons. Therefore, many studies are devoted to clarifying their content, the difference from dictionaries and glossaries, and the scope of their use. Emil Frumkin considers the lexicon as a mental phenomenon and state that the mental lexicon is that component of the grammar that contains all the information, phonological, morphological, semantic, and syntactic. According to Sova, the lexicon is a bridge between a language and the knowledge expressed in that language. Therefore, we consider such functions of online lexicons in the translation of specialized text. Online lexicons as sources of terminology. Online lexicons as sources of additional information. Online lexicons as translators tools. Our research is driven by the development of information technologies in translation, the need of translators for terminology, the need of translators for more information, possibilities of using open, reliable resources. Comparing the printed version of the lexicon with its online version, we can conclude that there are several advantages of the online lexicon, which we attributed to a better understanding of the key terms and concepts of the area. More data accumulated. The possibility of obtaining additional information by searching specialized vocabularies and glossaries linked by a number of links. Often, to receive a certain amount of material in PDF format, free of charge for printing and use. Visual textual material with numerous photos, drawings, tables, graphs. Continuous updating and up-to-date of the data presented in the empress of the main lexicon and related lexicons and glossaries. Availability of up-to-date information on the state of the relevant markets. An example is shown on the slide. The Agrarlexikon mit den wichtigsten Begriffen zur Landwirtschaft im europäischen Umfeld, Agricultural Lexicon with the most important agricultural terms in the European environment, was created as a part of the integrated biofactor project under the European Union, which aims to develop new approaches to the use of so-called biofactors. A detailed description of maize data, mice, covers a wide range of issues related to this crop, market information, prices, cultivation, pests and their manifestation, symptoms of maize damage, plant protection products with recommendation specifically for maize, general data on maize, biological characteristics, distribution history, statistics, etc. A valuable feature is that additional information can also be obtained from other sources by clicking on the hyperlink. The user receives a list of literature on the topic as well as a separate list of professional publications. Online lexicons are a valuable tool for translators because online lexicons are a source of domain-specific terminology. Online lexicons can be used by translators to obtain additional information about the subject of the translation. The amount of information in online lexicons is sufficiently large and constantly increasing. Compared with printed versions, the online versions provide a number of advantages. In particular, the continual updating of the vocabularies. Most online lexicons provide hyperlinks, allowing the translator to find additional information or terminology from other sources. As you can see, when comparing the Latin and German lexicons, they are similar in structure, and therefore using them by a translator to search for terms is very easy and quick. Given the fact that in some fields there are terminological nomenclatures which completely include all subject names, plants, animals, chemical elements, etc., translators can greatly facilitate their work and avoid terminological errors by using Latin lexicons as intermediate between the source and target languages. We have also identified areas for further research. These include the following: integration of online lexicons in the process of translators' training, expansion of domain-specific terminology researches, use of multimedia resources related to thematic networks for in-depth study of terminology, investigating of students' progress in the study of foreign languages for specific purpose. Thank you for your attention.